First of all, I want to give a hearty welcome and a tidal wave of love to each one of you. To the new seekers, I would like to share 5 points. They're going to be brief. Number one, the reality and objective of life is far more than what the average seeker initially perceives. You might feel you know what spirituality is, and in the most loving way, I would like to tell you that you don't have a clue. All you know is what religions, philosophies, and the occult has told you. All you know is the scriptures you have so devotedly read in the past, or what someone in authority, a minister, a bishop or priest, has told you. Spirituality is far more immense and infinite than what any seeker knows. I will give you, those that start the path, I will give you the freedom to see this for yourself, but it can be quite overwhelming. Point number two, the MasterPath specializes in not only discovering the hidden truth, truth is hidden, but also the realization of both the divine self and God. An average seeker of the world is told that God is all there is, that, hey, it's about worshiping and finding God. On a true light and sound path, which is esoteric by nature, you are basically informed that before God can be appreciated and worshiped and loved in the correct way, you have to find your true self, your soul. And as it stands right now, the soul is covered in a heap of illusion and karma and is unknown to the seeker of the world. And so the first and foremost issue, if you are interested in true spirituality, is finding yourself first. That's called self-realization. Man, know thyself, not sutin. And you must be in your higher spiritual divine self in order to even be able to conceive of an infinite God and to know how to love him and worship him. And so this is what a light and sound doctrine specializes in. It specializes in discovering the hidden truth, but also the realization of both the divine self and the Lord God. Point three, if you have any interest in this divine teaching, I urge you to investigate further to see if this doctrine holds anything for you. If it does, it's wonderful. If it doesn't, that's wonderful. And you say, how can that be wonderful? Well, if it doesn't have your interest, then something else does. If seventh grade doesn't have your interest, maybe third grade does. Maybe ninth grade does. But please, if you have any interest, take that as a sign and investigate further. You don't have to sign your life away. If you're supposed to walk this path, the Spirit will let you know through your experiences, your insights, and a number of other things that happen when the Spirit is trying to reel us in and when we are truly one of the called. Many are called, few are chosen. Point number four, I so appreciate any new seekers being in attendance this afternoon and tonight. You say, Gary, why would you say something so simple? Well, because it's the truth. I do appreciate it. The question is, do you know how infinite and broad the spiritual journey is? Anyone that comes into the orbit of any master walking this globe is blessed beyond measure. You could even go see one of these characters and even have a condescending attitude about your experience, and you would still be blessed beyond measure. So I appreciate any new seeker being in attendance this afternoon and tonight, because it's a beautiful foretaste of what your future experiences are going to entail. And point number five, the last point. Always, if possible, remember that if you are in search for a true path or master, understand that they are both in search of you. Critically important. You're not left out in the swamp. You're not left out in the cold. We're left to wonder, how do I count? Where do I turn to find some answers? Who can I trust? I don't know where to go. I just don't know. Well, there's forces at work that will help ameliorate that situation. If you're looking for a path and you're looking for a master, a bona fide master that you can trust in, and that doesn't come cheaply, they're looking for you. And that should be a note of reassurance and confidence, because now you can be expectant of hearing something from the other side to assist you in your search. Okay, that's the new seeker meeting. I think that's the shortest one I've ever done. Much love to you all. Many blessings to you.